Hello everyone and welcome back to the garden. Today we are going to be taking a closer look at seed stratification and more specifically what these different types of flower seeds actually need to get them growing. In general, you don't really run into seed stratification a lot in the vegetable garden, but it is something that is fairly common with flower seeds. They do, especially the long-lived perennial flower seeds, they do tend to be much more difficult to germinate, and that's simply because they have a kind of natural period of dormancy. What this dormancy does, it allows the seeds to not begin to germinate until the time is right, until they are able to truly thrive. However, depending upon your climate and where you live, you might need to get those seeds growing at a time that they don't really want to grow. So that's when the whole process of stratifying them really comes into play. Though in this video, I am using the word stratification as kind of a blanket term to describe different techniques needed for germination. I realize that's not accurate. There's also, scarification, for example. Scarification kind of refers to doing stuff to the seeds to help them germinate. So, for example, you might see that some seeds, the seed coat needs to be nicked or scratched with sandpaper or something like that before germination can get started, that moisture can really get in, that kind of thing. I personally don't really scarify my seeds in that way where I'm nicking the seed coat or anything. A lot of times you'll see that called for with seeds like sweet peas or seeds that have a really hard coat, mostly round seeds like nasturtiums, I think also call for that sometimes. In those cases, what I tend to do actually is scarification through soaking. There are different types of this, and when it comes to soaking, of course, some seeds respond better to warm water or hot water soaking. Some, it doesn't matter. Some, just room temperature water will get the job done. One example specifically of this that we're going to be starting this year are hollyhock seeds. I almost always soak hollyhock seeds in warm water before planting. It doesn't have to be, boiling water. In fact, I would recommend against using boiling water just because you don't want to accidentally, cook your seeds. But I find I just turn the hot tap water on, let it get as hot as it can go, fill up a jar, and then place my hollyhock seeds in. I then let those hollyhock seeds soak and cool down with that water, usually overnight. And then I will direct sow them into the garden, and we will have excellent germination rates with the hollyhocks. This is usually done at the end of September, middle September here in my yard, just so we can get that growth going before the winter so that those can overwinter and bloom the following summer. As I mentioned, sweet peas are another one that I like to soak. Ornamental sweet peas, the Lathyrus odoratus, I always soak those. I usually just use room temperature tap water, fill up a jar with those and put the seeds in, let those soak overnight. The next day, I will direct sow those into a well-prepared bed again for fall planting, usually about the end of September, and we'll have some really great germination. Just the end of September here in my yard, the temperatures have started to cool down a little bit. The daytime temperatures are still about, 80 Fahrenheit, 80 to 90 Fahrenheit, but the nighttime temperatures have started to cool down into the 60s, sometimes the 50s. So that's what I'm really looking for when I'm looking to germinate some of these hardy annual seeds that need a little bit of special treatment to get them growing. Again, the same can also be true with the springtime. If you're sowing in the springtime, if you have a different, more mild climate than I have here where I am, the reason I plant in the fall is because my climate does get pretty hot in summer and these more delicate flowers don't tend to like it. It just depends on what you're sowing and where you're sowing it. It takes a little bit of trial and error, but once you get it, it's pretty easy. One of the most common seed treatment methods you'll see is cold stratification, and this can be done in a variety of ways, as I've already mentioned. Some seeds will germinate better if they are stored in the refrigerator for about 2 weeks before their intended sow date. This will just mimic that cold weather that would be ideal before they germinate in the spring. So that might be something to consider. Seeds that I grow in the fall for hardy annuals that require this period, I definitely see that snapdragons have a much better germination rate when I refrigerate them first for 2 weeks. Also, in addition to snapdragons, things like the scabiosa pincushion flowers seem to have much better germination when they are refrigerated. I do not refrigerate any of my, you know, frost-sensitive flowers. When it comes to refrigerating seeds, I really just focus on the hardy annual flowers that do have that little bit of cold tolerance. Because in most cases, those seeds like to germinate when they're coming from winter temperatures, so it would make sense that cold is needed to kind of give them a kickstart in the fall to start growing. In addition to cold stratification, some seeds just do better with a combination of methods. For example, Bells of Ireland are extremely tricky to germinate, and for me, I was frustrated for years. So what happened, what I ended up doing, is a combination of two methods. What I ended up doing was taking my Bells of Ireland seed and wrapping them in a damp paper towel and placing that in a Ziploc bag. After I had done that, I placed that Ziploc bag in the refrigerator for 2 weeks. So we had a combination of a cold treatment and a combination of kind of a cold wet treatment that seemed to really, really help the germination rate of my Bells of Ireland this year. No, it still wasn't 100%, but it was noticeably better than in years past. So I'm really pleased with that. Really learning more about the specific type of seed that you are growing is so important when you are growing a cut flower garden. If you are growing in the fall, if you're sowing in the fall and planting hardy annuals to overwinter in the fall, it really is important to keep these, you know, kind of techniques in mind when you're planting and planning to make sure that you have the best results possible, because, you know, you can be easily disappointed if you don't kind of factor in these. If you are planting in the spring, again, also, you want to make sure that you are planting at the right time, giving those seeds the right conditions for optimal germination. And that's one of the main reasons that I am such a supporter of the winter sowing method, because with the winter sowing method with milk jugs as little greenhouses, if you're unfamiliar with what I'm talking about, I have tons of videos on it. Just search my channel. You should be able to find winter sowing. Those milk jugs as winter sowing containers, they do all the work for you, and that's especially great for beginner gardeners. You know, if those seeds need a little bit of cold, they're gonna get it and they're gonna grow well regardless of, you know, your expertise in it. That's really about it for this video. I hope that it was helpful. Hopefully you kind of have a better understanding of some of the things that I do to seeds to get them to grow to their, you know, full potential or to get their best germination rate possible. If you have any questions or tips or suggestions or anything like that, be sure to leave them down in the comments. I always love to hear from you guys. I'm always learning something from y'all, and I think it's really great. If you're new to the channel and you like the video, be sure to subscribe. We'd love to have you. We're gonna try to grow a really beautiful garden. Hopefully it'll work out. Tell a friend, all that good stuff. I hope that you guys are having an amazing day, and I will talk to you later. Bye, guys.